Hello everyone, I'm Mary's Farm here, and today I'm going to talk about DSB saying that he will always choose happiness over the rich lifestyle, like he had in the past. Yeah, okay, let's just get right into it.
Years when I was popular, my shit didn't stink, and everyone was talking about Darkside Phil, checking out the hottest new Darkside Phil playthrough. I was going to conventions, people were lining up, yes, I'm not kidding, people were lining up to get my autograph, people wanted to go to a big event.
Don't you wish you could take that back, Philip? Really, don't you wish...
You know, in a ballroom to watch me and talk with me and see a panel with me on it. Yes, I know that's crazy to think, because today no one gives a shit. But back then people actually did. You know, these were the earlier years of YouTube, okay? First of all, that's false.
Honestly, I think if Phil did a panel now, he would still get like a couple people showing up to it, but yeah. He's irrelevant as shit.
That was definitely a different time, alright? And my life was dramatically different, okay? I was single, I was living alone, and quite frankly, I was coming out of a time in my life where I was pretty strongly into depressed. I was heavy depression. Okay? And, you know, I didn't like who I was. I didn't like where my life was going. And YouTube kind of turned that all around for me. Admittedly, if I didn't have that YouTube positivity going on in my life, I don't know where I'd be today. Okay? And the thing was, those years were very unhealthy for me. All right? I was basically drinking myself to sleep every night. This is not exaggerating. This is my life. I was drinking an insane amount of, like...
Wait, so I don't understand. You said YouTube was your positivity light, but, like, you were at your worst in depression?
Rum and Coke every night. Like, Coke Zero and rum.
I fell asleep.
And I would play games, and then I would like watch some TV, have some unhealthy food, pass out, wake up the next day late, like noon or later. Oh, I gotta start recording. Set up my setup, start playing video games, record, you know, all day, start uploading, run and buy fast food, every day fast food. Literally every day fast food. Okay?
Wow. And I'm pretty sure it's the same now though. Like almost every day you're having fast food.
Then, you know, come back, record more, upload. And that was my life 6 days a week. The one day a week I did, okay, I take that back, 5 days a week. One day a week, John Rambo would come over, and instead of me just doing that solo, we'd actually do co-op commentary. We'd do our Smart Guys wrestling show, and we'd do a co-op playthrough together, which was really nice. And then another day a week, Sundays, every Sunday night, I would go and I would have dinner with my parents. So I'd meet with them somewhere, or they would meet me at my condo, or I'd go there, and we'd drive to like a restaurant, we'd have a nice meal out, we'd talk about our week, get caught up, and I would see them then. And that was literally my life. Every once in a while, I'd break it up.
And this was like beginning of YouTube. His life is exactly the same now, except him going out for dinner with his family is replaced with him going out for dinner with Kat. Yikes. And he said this was like the lowest of his life. Dude, I think now might be the lowest.
We're going to a convention, or going to E3, or you know what I mean? But that was my life for years. Like we're talking like, you know, 2011, 2012, 2013, 3-4 years in a row. That was my life. And it was not a good life, all right? It wasn't. It was busy, it was hectic, I was making tons of money. But it was incredibly stressful. It was incredibly unhealthy. I did a lot of irresponsible things during those years I shouldn't have done, right? I ruined a lot of friendships. I'm being honest here now. You know, I ruined a lot of friendships with me basically becoming like a workaholic and only caring about the videos, and putting out more videos. And a lot of irreparable harm was probably done to my life.
It's the same now, Philip. It literally is the same now. You can't take one day off with your wife. It's sad. How much damage have you done to your relationship with your wife and the relationship with your family just for a stream? Make a couple hundred dollars, not even a couple hundred dollars, like, you're still doing the same thing now.
During that time frame, okay? I said I did a lot of stupid things that I regret now, in my videos, outside of my videos, right? And you could look back and say, well, Phil was so popular back then on YouTube, you know, all his videos, he put out a new playthrough of Zelda, part one would have 50 plus thousand views, every part after that would have 10,000 views, Phil would have 1 million views on a new playthrough within 2 days, can you imagine the money he was making? You're right, but it wasn't a healthy life, and it wasn't a happy life, there was really no life. It was just the videos. It was fucked up. But that was who I was.
Except. People really don't understand what they're saying. Or like what's coming out of their mouth sometimes. Especially Phil. You're saying. Back in the day it was so much more depressing. And how all this stuff was happening. But all this stuff is like the same that you're explaining it. Like this, your life is exactly the same. Nothing has changed. Except you make less money. You have less of a fan base, and yeah, less people are willing to give you a fair shake. So, what's different?
What was back then, you know? And what I learned over time, you know, through trial and error, that's for sure, is that you need to have a line that you draw, if you're a content creator, between your public and your private life, and you need to have limits. You need to have barriers and boundaries, because if you don't, then your entire life becomes bullshit drama on the internet.
What the fuck? Okay.
Yikes.
And that's literally what happened to me, right? And I don't want my whole life to be bullshit drama on the internet anymore. You know, I've been there, I've done that, I lived it, I hate it. I really do, I hate it. That's why I have done my absolute best in the last 5 years, 6 years to separate my private life from my public life. That's why, you know, the life that my wife and I have here behind the scenes has nothing to do with the public eye at all, nor should it. We have our own things going on that no one knows about, and that's intentional. No one has the right to know everything about everyone's life. You have no right to try to pry into someone's personal matters. You understand? It's fucked up for people who try to do that. Like, you're nuts. You're a loser to try to mess with someone's personal ongoings. It's none of your business. If there's something on someone's stream or in someone's content, that's one thing. But the moment that you try to pry into the private, that's none of your fucking business. You got problems, man.
I agree with what Phil's saying here to, like, some degree. I'm pretty sure he's, like, kind of getting into, like, the Keemstar thing where Keemstar's, like, calling his family now and, like, you know, trying to set up, like, interviews. I kind of understand that in some way. But, I don't really understand what this has to do with you not wanting to be rich or famous and how you'd rather it be now. I don't know. Very weird comparison.
Gotta go see help. Gotta see a doctor about that. Because it's obsession. And, sadly, you know, we're our victim to that. You know? Do you think snorting and throat clearing is a tick or a symptom of Tourette's? Yes. As you all know, guys, I'm a victim of our life together. You know, over 5 years ago, things have been dramatically better. My life has dramatically improved. As you can see, I've gotten more healthy. I'm eating better.
So as you can see, this was another woe was me, woe was Phil fest, where he complains about my life was so bad back in the day when I was so depressed and drinking myself and blah blah blah. I never had no time off for anything compared to now where, oh, he's so happy apparently with Kat. He makes way less money, gets way less viewers, and he doesn't get any time off, just like the past. So I don't know where he was going with this. There was no, like, positive comparison here. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe for more if you like my coverage. And if you want to make me smile, I have an Amazon wish list down below. Have an amazing day, guys. Bye-bye.